Galaxy S8 owners around the world will soon be getting their first major Android update. The upgrade to Oreo, Android 8.0, keeps the core GS8 experience the same, but brings welcome performance tweaks and a handful of new features on top of everything this phone could already do. I'm Alex from Android Central, and this is what's new in Android Oreo for the Samsung Galaxy S8. So first of all, your Galaxy S8 is still a Galaxy S8. This update doesn't make any drastic changes to the overall look or feel of Samsung's software, even though we're technically up to version 9 of the Samsung experience now. Of course, this is Android Oreo, so you get all the features we've been seeing in Pixel phones and some others of the past few months now. Things like improved notification management, notification channels, and the ability to snooze alerts that aren't important right this second. It's also easier to sign into apps for the first time. Autofill with Google pulls in details automatically from your Google account. Take a look at our Android 8.0 video review to see what else is new in Oreo itself. On the Samsung side, what's most noticeable is how much faster the S8 is on Oreo. It's subtle, but everything seems just a bit quicker than before, thanks to optimizations from both Google and Samsung. And Samsung's feature set continues to grow. The edge panels have been redesigned a little, and now include the option, from the Note 8, to create pairs of apps that open automatically in multi-window mode. Edge lighting has also been upgraded with a bunch of different options to change the color and style of alerts around the edge of the display. You can choose to have different animation styles, sizes, and have your edge lighting looking subtle or completely garish. Another minor visual tweak, there are more clock styles to choose from now, and you can control how the clock looks on both the always-on display and the lock screen. Samsung's launcher has finally been updated to support app shortcuts, which were missing from Android 7.1 on the Note. Between that and new notification badges in 8.0, it means you get a bunch of new stuff in this little menu behind each icon. You can uninstall or remove them, see notifications in a list, or jump to specific areas of an app. And because notifications are fully tied into this menu now, swiping them away here also dismisses them from the notification shade as well. Dual Messenger is something that you may have come across on dual SIM Samsung phones before, and now it's just a fully standard Samsung feature in this latest update. Messaging and social apps like Facebook, WhatsApp, WeChat, and others can now be duplicated, letting you sign into two accounts at once at the same time. You'll literally get two of your chosen app's icon on your home screen, and you can juggle between them as you please, moving between accounts as you go. Speaking of WhatsApp, there's another small but actually really useful fix in the Samsung Gallery app on Oreo. You can finally tell it to hide and ignore certain folders. So if you don't want random WhatsApp images being pulled into your albums, it's now easy to hide these folders completely. Kind of amazing it took so long for this option to arrive, but great that it's finally here. And last but not least, there's a new version of the Samsung keyboard, which feels a bit more responsive than before, and now includes a built-in GIF keyboard for when only a short meme-filled animation will get the message across. It doesn't work perfectly with every app right now, but it is a nice option to have. And that's about it for now for Oreo on the Samsung Galaxy S8. Again, Samsung isn't making any sweeping changes here, and if there's anything we should read into that about the Galaxy S9, then perhaps we shouldn't expect a huge software overhaul on that phone either. In the meantime, S8 and Note 8 owners should start receiving this update in early 2018. Stay tuned to androidcentral.com for more on the update when it arrives, and subscribe to us here on YouTube so you don't miss all of our future coverage. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.